feels at times that some of it starts to get pretty heady, and yet I also, my wonder is about the simplicity, an idea of a model like this, that on some level, there's some things I can never really touch, that I'm not really, in that I am here, I am defined by...
With this model, you can. This is the beauty of the model.
Okay, okay.
This is what makes this model so unique. It's very simple, but extremely profound, if you are able to really reach its depth. Anything you think, it's here.
Well, the thing you're speaking to is reducing it down. Like, if I can think of creation, if I can get past myself as a human being, and I can start to even fathom or imagine that every subparticle is its own creation of these bodies, meaning what we're having a conversation, it seems sometimes to make my head spin. It goes wide and wide and big and big. But then what you're on some level doing is reducing it down to, like, it's not simplistic, but the meaning behind this is that whether we're human or bear or rock or planet, this is the same thing as what you're speaking.
This is from the whole creation. I'm using the human, as I said, because it's the creation that most of us are familiar with. Otherwise, everything can be here.
So following that, the ideas of specifications of sensory perception, there's something I got lost in when you were describing that the entities, let's say, that live in an astral sense, live really closely related to us. I got stuck on that. I'm trying to understand. There's a couple words, parallel universe, there's a few different things. I would like to revisit that idea. I'm getting lost in an idea of people who have, let's say, that physical substance. They're living and they're alongside us, but I can't perceive them. Do you know what I mean? That part of the conversation, I got confused.
If I may, from what you're talking about, and when you're working with somebody and you're feeling what they're feeling, and you're changing them on a fundamental level with healing, and you're talking about other beings and yourself and your own perception, it comes down to the filter that he was talking about, because there's different levels of perception, the free will, and there's filters between the physical and the emotional and the mental. So when we're growing, when we're healing, when we're learning, when even like, because the filter between a bear and the soul might be, the filter might be thinner because they don't have the, their filter might be thinner, so they're more perceptive on this extrasensory level. Like, their instincts are stronger, but we have the free will, we have the different perspectives of being taught a certain way that our filter's thicker. And some people who are given a God-given gift, their filter might be a little bit thinner. So that when we're healing people, we're really helping them dissolve their filter so that they can see more. They can.
So the thing we're talking about is perception? Is it coming down to perspective then? Is that what you know what I mean?
No, she's using the filter as a separator. I'm using the filter as a limitation for the formation according to knowledge.
The
consciousness is the filter.
Yeah, yeah.
The fact that there is a difference of density from here, there, and from here, and there, for me, it's just a physical expression of the creation, okay? Which is expressed, this limitation is actually the result of God's desire and design to create for us a space-time continuum.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
This, on the other hand, it is the level, this is extrasensory,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This astral, yeah. Yeah. But this is where the real implementation occurs.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
For example, during the cycle of development of a human or any creature, okay, the emotional body is the same throughout this implementation cycle. Every incarnation has the same emotional body. Every incarnation has the same emotional body. So this one is repeating with another dress, as a man or as a woman or something else, okay? It's repeating until it is ready, it is achieved its purpose of development, And then we are talking about transfiguration. We are talking about change of soul, because the real vehicle of the soul is this body. And this is nothing more than a way of expressing this body for the time being. Concurrently can be other bodies as well. This is why, for us, when we are looking at a physical body, we should never forget that the physical body, as I said in the beginning of this presentation, it's only what our senses permit us to see. In reality, what each one of us is this auric field, where everything is in. Okay? And that's why when we show the aura of a person is not only we openly accept that it is the emotional content of a creature. We forget, because most of the people cannot delve enough into these questions to reach to very robust theories, but in reality, with the crude instruments we have available to us right now, the aura, yes, it is the emotional charge of the time being, but also it shows peak experiences from other incarnations of the same soul. Okay? For example, you can see in the aura a person who has been harmed by a profound, ugly experience in another life. And that may appear in the physical life as a phobia, or may appear as a limitation. And once we reach to the point of explaining to the person what's happening and lives through that and accept it, he's liberalized. Okay?
You had a question?
No, just
so all I'm saying is that this explains the fundamental question, why so many researchers using aura have realized that they can help a person to dissolve certain negative situation through doing past life regression or even progression. Because that happens. There is a lot of research material. And what I'm telling you explains everything is here. And when, and I will insist on that, that's book number 5. When you reach...
You really should write these.
I have written these.
I know, they're already here. Yeah.
Can you read them?
That's why it's good, we're going to record you.
Anyway, so when the terms of reference is complete, then where the soul actually goes where it started, which is the spiritual body. And it is reconfigured for another cycle, and it returns for a new adventure, forthcoming.
I'm out of the hot seat. Yeah, I understand that better that time. All right.
Εγώ καλύτερα δεν κατάλαβα. Better I understand in the English language than the Greek.
You understand better in English?
Yes.
So don't miss a chance.
No?
Because we're going to have other meetings as well while I'm here.
Okay.
But you have to come to Belgium. Okay, I think we had a wonderful discussion. Thank you guys very
much.
Thank you, Stefan.
Thank you for being here. Hope you enjoyed as much as I